Hi, I'm Chris Nyogi, and I'm the chair of ASPB's Charles Albert Shull Award Committee. The Shull Award is given annually to a mid-career scientist in recognition of outstanding investigations in the field of plant biology. It is my great pleasure to introduce Adrian Roeder, who was selected by our committee as the 2021 recipient of the Charles Albert Shull Award. Congratulations, Adrian. How are you feeling?
I'm going to Disneyland. just kidding. I'm really honored to receive this award. I'm grateful first and foremost to my current and former lab members. This award really recognizes all of them as well as me. I'm grateful to my collaborators, my mentors, my colleagues, and the plant biology community. Thank you all for your support and this recognition of my research.
Maybe you could tell us a little bit more about your research and what you've been recognized for.
So the research in my lab focuses on two interrelated questions. First, we want to know how do cells know what size to be, and how does the plant actually generate a diversity of cell sizes? So how does it generate variability? Second, and related to that, how do organs composed of these cells know what size and shape to be, and how do they get to reproducible or robust size and shape despite all the variability in the cell sizes and shapes and the randomness that's going on at the cellular level? So we're really fascinated by these two interrelated questions. We study these questions in the Arabidopsis sepal, which is the outermost green floral organ, because it's a great model system for understanding morphogenesis, or the generation of shape and form. And we like to take a computational morphodynamics approach to studying these questions, where we use molecular genetics to perturb the system and generate mutants that have different cell sizes or organ sizes. And then we use live imaging of these developing sepals and follow each of the cells as they divide and grow to understand how they generate the organ with the right shape and size.
Very cool. It sounds like you're addressing really fundamental questions. So do you have a message that you would like to convey to grad students who are watching this video?
So to the graduate students, I really recommend you watch Yuri Alon's TED Talk, where he describes being scientifically lost in the cloud. You're lost in the cloud when none of your experiments are working out as expected, and you feel stuck and you have no idea where you're going in your research. And it's a really uncomfortable feeling. And the reason you're lost in the cloud is because the actual hypothesis you have that's probably embedded in the field is wrong, and it's not answering what's going on in the biology. And so you keep doing experiments and more experiments, and you slowly start to understand and change that hypothesis to a new hypothesis. Every time that I've actually made a real important scientific finding in my career, I've been lost in the cloud first. And so what I encourage you to do is embrace this feeling of being lost in the cloud, appreciate it, use it to drive yourself forward to do those experiments, because that will actually lead you to make an important new discovery. So don't back away from being lost in the cloud. It's a sign you're on the right track.
Well, that's great advice. Congratulations, Adrian.
Thank you.